Dan, he's trying to get in the back of the shot.
I knew he was
trying to get in the shot. Trying to get full club all the way. Trying to get in the shot.
Ali Drew for BBTV at Fight Zone, joined by Dave Allen and his protege, Joe. So Dave, just start with you. You've got your comeback fight. You've announced you're coming back out of retirement. Just talk me through the process, thought process of coming out of retirement now.
Well, basically, I was retired for about 6 months. And I was managing a few fighters. I managed Levi Quinciona, Stevie Levy. I've got a few others that have not made the pro debut yet. And I get in touch with Eddie one out of every 32 calls. So it was like, it was getting a bit difficult trying to work with Eddie. So it was like, what can I do to get him busy? And I was bored at home, you know. So what I did is, I rung Dennis, yeah. And I thought, I saw the Fight Zone thing happening. And I just thought there's a chance there. So I spoke to Den about like the lads and that. Yeah, maybe I could have got them out, but more I can get out the fire box. Every time I box, two of my boys get the box as well, so, and girls. So it was just a great deal, and I thought, I don't need to come back and have massively hard fights. I can come back and just box and enjoy it. And people, I think people want to watch me box, whoever I'm boxing. So it just made sense. Just made sense for the people I work with, and I want to say business sense, but I'm not really a businessman, so it just made sense.
Because you've signed a promotion deal with Dennis as well, the Fight Zone, is that right?
I don't think so.
No?
No. What I've done is, me and Dennis have got an agreement that I'll box on these shows. I can box on any show in the world. I can box on any show. I can box on Fight Zone shows. My plan is to fight on Fight Zone. That is my plan. My plan is to have all my fights on Fight Zone. I can box anywhere. So if things are going well, going really well, I get offered a big fight, I go and take that fight elsewhere. But the plan is Fight Zone becomes big. It becomes really big, and I can stay on here even if I go on to want big fights again. But the plan in the immediate future is just to do 4 and 6 rounders against opponents that like we don't know. It could be anybody really.
And do you know an opponent?
Well, you know, there's names flying about. But I'll be boxing 4 and 6 round opponents that you can start your career with. I'm not boxing 18 months, fam. The last time I had a proper fight, I left on the stretch unconscious, paralysed. So I don't know what's left, to be honest. I might even get beat by like a Louis van Poet or something. You don't know, do you? So let's wait and see.
And your fight is scheduled now for August 27th,
yeah,
is that right?
Yeah.
So are you in full camp and getting ready?
Yeah, I've never trained as hard as this. I've got a nutritionist, John Clark Nutrition, on Instagram. I work with John, my nutrition stuff. I do my semi-conditioning. And I do some boxing. I'm just getting, at the minute I'm fit. I was 21 stone in January. I was massive. I was really big. I was unfit. I weren't feeling too great. And I've lost about 2.5 stone. I've started to start getting fit. But actually, I've got a good stable of fighters as well that I train as well. So I work alongside them. I've lost the weight. I'm 11 weeks away. When I never started training until 5 weeks before. So the fact that I'm doing a little bit 11 weeks out is a great sign that I'll be fit on the night.
And who's your coach? What's your coaching team?
My coach is David Allen Senior at the minute. My old man had 100 fighters amateur pro. My old man knows what he's doing. He's not the greatest padman in the world, but he's my dad, isn't he? And he knows his stuff, so I work with him. I've got a strength conditioner. I've got a nutritionist. I've never been as professional, really. So, like I said, as we move down the line and I have fights, hopefully win them and start to feel good, then I would think about what I'm doing. But at the minute, my plans are literally to have 4 and 6 rounders, win them, the lads get busy, and then I can go and go back to being a pundit, a commentator, and all the other things that I can do as well. So I'm not really thinking of coming back having big fights. I'm just coming back to enjoy it, get the lads going, and just enjoy it, because I'm only young once, aren't I? And once it's gone, it's gone. And I was seeing it was gone at a point, and I thought, no, I'm gonna go get it back. So I took it back, and I'm just enjoying it. I'm enjoying it more now than I was when I was headlining the O2 and stuff, because the pressure was amazing. I went from literally a nobody headlining the O2 in the space of 18 months. It was all a bit much for me, so I was gonna enjoy doing what I did.
And how do you balance your training with coaching and managing?
Well, obviously, I'm a great trainer, I think, because I care though. I'm not saying I'm the greatest boxing trainer, but I care for them. I put 100% into them. I put much more into them than I ever did myself. But I really do care about them, and I know what I'm doing. I know the crowd, I've got the contacts. We spar everywhere, the boys do. The boys get the best of everything, to be honest. They get anything they could possibly want, I can provide them with that. And on top of that, I've got a lot of experience, so I think I'm a decent boxing coach. I'm only young, I don't know everything, otherwise Otherwise, what will I be doing? I don't know. I've completed it already, one of my hands. So, what I'm thinking is, I'll just give them everything they need. And I watched them succeed. I had Danny Morrell, he's moved on to Dominic Ingle. I rung Dom, I said, Dom, will you train him? I flat out my own boxing. And I took him as far as I think I can take him. So, I need you now with your experience to see if you can get more out of him. So, I enjoy the training. I don't enjoy the managing as much as the training, because the managing's hard work. You try ringing 800 people a day and only get 3 answers. It's hard. But it's not hard to balance it, because a lot of the training we do side by side, we run together, we do our strength training together. Joe lifts the same weight as me, because I'm not very strong at lifting weights. He lifts the same as me anyway. But and the boxing's like kind of do all the sessions together, so it's not. It is a little bit time consuming, but I've got nothing but time, as you know. I've got loads of free time, so there we go.
And we're just bringing Joe Hayden, one of your proteges. What's it like training alongside Dave?
Yeah, it's good. Now that he's back fully training, getting fully fit, it's amazing. It pushes us that extra bit when we're doing those runs, and you've got a big white rhino behind you breathing on you. You're running a bit faster, and with lifting weights as well, whatever he puts on bar, that's what you're lifting. So yeah, it's good. I'm really enjoying training with Dave.
And is there any news of fights for you coming up?
Not a minute, no. We're waiting for England Boxing to let our missus back at it, and then as soon as we're allowed, we'll be fighting and stuff like that.
What's the best thing about
him? The experience that he brings, because obviously, you see the coaches that Dave's had. He's been with Peter Fury, he's been with Ingle Gym, and he's been with Jamie Moore, and he's getting all these little bits of experience all these other gyms, and he's bringing it all to us, and the techniques out of everyone, and bring it all to us. So yeah, I like that. And the opportunities that we get as well with the sparring, we get great sparring all over the country, and now that lockdown's finished, we'll be going all over the country sparring, and that's another great thing that happens. Though,
did you enjoy coming to events like this and getting to see, you know, professional fights and getting to experience it all?
Hopefully when I turn pro, it give me a bit more confidence. Though it won't be new to me when I turn pro and I come to events like this, because I've been coming now with Dave, and it'll be like the same experience, but instead of watching, I'll actually be fighting. So yeah, I look forward to it.
You want
punditry
duties tonight?
Punditry, commentary, Fight Zone analyst. I do all of it. Yeah. So something I really enjoy doing all that. Something it's you know, obviously I was about to say something I wasn't sure I shouldn't have said then. But anyway, I'm really enjoying doing all of it. Yeah. So it's I like to think I can do it everything, you know. And as a boxer, I was never really not taken seriously, but I was always like, people always said this is what I was going to end up doing, you know. So I'm doing it. I'm the boxing, I'm the coaching, I'm the managing, a bit of everything. So I'm really enjoying my life hockey right now, and it's great.
What's your favourite out of all the stuff you do?
I really enjoy training. I know Joe's here now, and I've got to say, but I enjoy it. There's no better feeling than the other day. Yeah, I don't give my address out to anyone, right? So when I get stuff sent, it goes straight to Joe's house. There's no better feeling than I know really good box of stuff is going to Joe's house, and he gets to open it and he's excited what's in there, because we got some body warmers the other day. Yeah, what else did we get? We got some coffee sent the other day, and I love it, me, because what, like with him and Liam and the others, I know I only wish when I was amateur boxer or starting out as a pro, I wish I had someone like me that could have done that. Like, he goes to every show that he can possibly go to. He'd be going to the matchroom show tomorrow, but he's working. He goes everywhere to get the best of everything, and that gives me a great sense of pride and achievement that I can give these boys something I never had and that most don't get. So it does put a bit of pressure on them, but I think pressure is good in boxing, because as you know, pressure either makes you or breaks you. So I've got a lot of belief in them, and also it's like my best night in boxing wasn't winning the O2 or all the other stuff. It was when I first did the amateur corner for Danny and Liam. I felt like I'd won the lottery that night, because they both won, and it was just amazing. And it was the best thing ever, so I can't wait for them to get back amateur boxing, my pros to get fighting, because when they win, it just gives me a bigger buzz than they ever got when I won. I don't even know why, but it's amazing. So yeah, probably training them. In short, training them.
Well, I'll leave you to all your duties and your views to enjoy the show.
Thank you, Ali.
Thanks.
Cheers.